Let's go.
Basketball action at Quicken Loans Arena in downtown Cleveland, Ohio. The home of the Cavaliers, live on 2K Sports. It's Wednesday Night Basketball, live on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. You look at Portland. Absolutely filthy.
And the building is stunned, partner. He dug deep into his bag.
I tell you what, I hope he keeps that one handy. I want to see that one again.
How's that for an answer? Right back with the dunk.
How about the excitement right now that he's playing the game with? I love it.
He capped that dunk off with some serious hang time on the rim.
I tell you what, he just couldn't contain himself on that one.
The drive by James.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
And, you know, the defense gets their money's worth on that foul, stopping the layup and not giving up the and one.
LeBron James.
And good on the second, so he makes them both.
Thank you, Cleveland!
And here are the Trailblazers. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Warriors.
Throughout the first half, even into the third quarter, they had the game totally under control. But, man, they just fell apart, collapsed in the fourth quarter. They should not have lost this game.
You know, I really think that they thought the game was over. And oftentimes, as soon as you start to look ahead, you lose that momentum. And then you can't recover. And that seemed to be the case in that one. I tell you what, guys, it's going to be a tough day on this defense. And he's got the A game rolling tonight.
Lillard dishes to Aminu. Kicks it to Plumlee. That's his second shot and his second basket. He's 2 for 2.
And he'll take it right into the teeth of the D without thinking twice about it.
Plumlee with the steal. And it's McCollum in the corner. Over in the corner, Lillard. Pass to Harkless. And stolen by Love. Oh, and here we go. Irving's got it. The fast break chance. The dish to Aminu. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Lillard.
Excellent work there in transition.
Yeah, I think it's always better to go early in transition to attack.
Thompson misses.
And you can see the defender's afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Two shots coming up.
Cavaliers have gone two for four.
Perfect attacking. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot.
6 seconds left to play here in the first. Shoots the three. No good trying to beat the buzzer. Both teams have it going here early and still close through the first quarter. It's the Trailblazers up by two. And we'll be back in just a moment with the start of the second quarter. Close game here as we get back to the second quarter. And what do you guys think so far about the offensive approach for the Trailblazers?
Guys, their penetration has been outstanding. I mean, it's actually been great. They're really finding those holes in the defense.
And also, it's been a positive to watch that they've attacked the paint offensively as well. It's really been about the balance that they've shown.
LeBron and Love are the talented pair at the forward position. Kyrie Irving is out there with Matthew Dellavedova. And it's Fry in at the center position. That's the group for Cleveland going right now here in the second. Outside Irving. Battles through traffic and lays it in. Irving's got his second basket of the night.
You know, huge height advantage there. But because of the great body control, he's able to cancel it out.
Agreed. The body control essential in that situation. I mean, if you're giving up a bunch of height, then you better be able to manufacture things in the air.
Delavadova, that's good.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
And, you know, it doesn't matter how good your defense is on the perimeter if you're going to allow easy ones inside like that.
And Damian Lillard with the jam.
And that is a major league flush right there, my friends.
And in a tight contest like this, Greg, that might be just what they need to get the tide rolling in their direction.
You're exactly right. I mean, so often when a team gets that kind of explosive play out of its backcourt, that can really rally and galvanize the whole squad. When he's wide open like that, he'll rarely miss those.
Irving kicks to Dellavedova. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. Irving's got his third assist on the night.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Everybody on the same page, completely in sync. Tremendous communication and awareness.
Lillard attacking. Picked away. And here we go. Fast break. Love's got it. James with the bucket.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
And I think taking a time here to talk things over is a smart idea.
One of the things you want to do is make sure everybody is clearly on the same page with the game plan. And sometimes you need a timeout to make sure that's the case.
So timeout called here, the first for Portland. Look at LeBron James. He's really been playing well.
He's been attacking the rim with reckless abandon. They're searching for answers. Some way they've got to figure out how to contain it.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. Thompson's checked in. Mason Plumlee's checked in for the Trailblazers. McCollum comes in for Allen Crabbe. Lillard attacking. Here's Plumlee. He makes another one. That's four up and four in to start his game.
His eyes were wide open there, guys. Excellent vision to see they had an open shot outside and get it there. They're forcing the ball inside, and it's working beautifully.
It really is. Five out of six of their last field goals have come from the paint.
Misses the three. For the Cleveland Cavaliers, they come in off the loss to Atlanta. LeBron, no luck. Now the feed to McCollum. Fires for three. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Lillard. And that's now 7 points for C.J. McCollum. It's deflected. And they're able to recover. Dellavedova dishes to Irving. And stolen by Lillard. And here we go. Trailblazers with a fast break. And McCollum with the slam.
And guys, that's a big swing right there. I mean, taking the steal and then turning it into two easy points on the dunk.
No telling how important that sequence could turn out to be.
And guys, in a game this snug, moments like that are the ones we usually look back on at the end as a difference maker.
Timeout called the Cavaliers. Some changes. Mozgov, he's checked in for Love. Smith comes in for James. And it's Iman Shumpert in for Matthew Dellavedova. And a switch here also for Portland. Al Farouk Aminu, he's checked in for Ed Davis. Portland's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. It's stolen by Smith. To the inside. Here's Irving. Softly drops in the floater. Irving's got 4 points this quarter. And guys, let's get your take on the hustle stats for the Cavaliers.
Boy, they've really amped up the pressure at the defensive end, guys, and have piled up the steals in the early going.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
Clock is at three. Lillard attacking. Beat the shot clock, but it's off the mark. Mozgov kicks to Shumpert. The screen from Thompson. Shumpert passes to Irving. From the top of the key, and Cleveland again with the bucket.
And started hot, and he's only gotten hotter.
Trailblazers trailed by four. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. And it's Lillard again missing.
Better not make a habit of...
To the paint. It's tipped. Here we go, one-on-one. Here's Irving. Lillard with the block. And out of bounds as the Trailblazers gain possession.
A temporary lapse of focus from him on that turnover. It's embarrassing, but on occasion it does happen.
Near the three-point line, it's McCollum. No good on the buzzer beater. And so it's a close game as we wrap up the first half of basketball. Cavaliers lead by four. Time now for the halftime break, with the third quarter soon to follow, right here on 2K Sports. Here we go now, the start of the third quarter, welcoming you back in a closely contested first half so far. What can you say, LeBron James, what an impressive effort today.
The way he was able to attack the rim in that first half, defenders are going to need to start building walls and being connected defensively if they want to have any chance to stop it.
Now, come on, Greg, that's much easier said than done when he's a penetrator. I mean, his speed and agility make him extremely tough to cover.
The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. What can you say, LeBron James? What an impressive effort today.
Yeah, you just love it when the decision-making is as good as it was there in that first half. Didn't force anything.
Guys, I think here in the second half, though, they may want him to be a little more assertive. Start hunting more for him.
Lillard at the point with C.J. McCollum playing the two. Al Farouq Aminu is up there with Mo Harkless. And it's... Plumlee in at the five, down low. McCollum with the ball. Now Smith defending. And stolen by Love. So the whistle blows on the shot, and two free throws for the contact right there. The Cavaliers have been solid at the line so far. 4 for 4.
And 75% on the season as a unit from the free throw line.
And guys, that allows their opponents to play very aggressive defense if they choose to, knowing it's not a bad thing to send them to the foul line.
To the left wing, Harkless dishes to Aminu. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up.
And now here are the teams that have been beating up. Man, you lagging heavy.
And after defending on the shot, he doesn't give up on the play. Follow that straight to the glass And Lillard kicks the Plumlee.
It's stolen by Smith.
And now that's Plumlee can pick up the ball. Thompson went up on it.
Bullshit, man. It's a lie.
Yeah, it sure has been. I mean, all you have to do is look up and down.
And Nate Davis is checked in for Alfa Romeo.
Damn, man, this shit fucking lagging. Just bugging, man.
Here's Trent.
Looking for the first basket.
Straight down.
And if that doesn't get them fired up, guys, nothing will.
Greg, just what the doctor ordered, huh? Some high-flying antics to narrow the deficit.
Tell you what, fellas, that could give them the energy boost they've been looking for.
Timeout called, Cleveland. the Cavaliers. Mozgov, he's checked in for Thompson. Fry comes in for Kevin Love. And Shumpert in there for Smith. And the Trailblazers making a change here as well. Roberts checked in. All sorts of time. And that one's good, Shumpert. And the Cavaliers lead by 7. A minute 42 left to play in the third. Pass to Vonleh. It's Henderson on the wing. Now Cleveland moving it up. Here's Shumpert. That drops, and it comes off an assist from Dellavedova. And now a 9-point Cavalier lead.
You know, one aspect of their play today that's really been tight and far superior is their passing.
And that kind of flow can be elusive, but the great offenses have it, and that's just what they've shown here tonight.
The Cavaliers leading by 7. Feeds to Mozgov. Power down with both hands.
Taking it to the rack with power right there.
And oh. Hammering down with the two-handed slam.
Just piling on the lead with the dunk like that.
Davis with it. Now defended by Mozgov. Here's Henderson. Shot is off. Shumpert with some nice deep.
A slight advantage for them in the rebound department, but that oftentimes is all it takes.
Especially, Greg, when you're scoring the ball at a decent clip the way they have. I mean, they've done exactly what's necessary to take the lead.
Irving's checked in for Matthew Dellavedova. Passes it to Mozgov. And stolen by Vonleh. Here's Henderson. It's rebounded by Cleveland.
Oh, that's terrific defense there. That's how you protect the rim.
Well, he won't miss many of those, especially with the defender not in the best of positions there.
And the Cavaliers pushing it up now. James with the ball.
And this is why you need good defenders on the interior to contest shots.
Yeah, Greg, making every shot a hard one, even the shots in close.
And that does it for the third quarter. Both teams clicking offensively as we approach the fourth quarter. Cavaliers on top, up 9. And we'll be back with you right after this.
Check it out.
Well, welcome back as we get set to start the fourth. Trailblazers trail by 9. J.R. Smith and LeBron at the 2 and 3. Tristan Thompson is out there with Kevin Love. And it's Irving at the 1. So that's who's on the 4 for the Cavaliers. To the middle. It's tipped. And stolen by Lillard. On up the court. Finished off the break. Lillard's got the fourth quarter started here with a bucket for the Trailblazers. Irving attacking. Good, and the assist goes to James. And that's now 10 points for Kyrie Irving.
Boy, they are passing the ball very crisply right now.
They really are, and their last 3 buckets have come by way of an assist.
Dishes to Cramp. Out to the wing. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Plumlee. Oh, yes, he did. 5 up and 5 down for him so far.
And you know what? One of the few bright spots in this game for them today. He's kept his edge even though they've been trailing.
And the shot is good.
And that's sort of been the story here today, hasn't it?
Kicks it to Craig. Tipped away. Stolen by Thompson. Here's Irving. Lillard with the block. To McCollum. Lets it go from 11. But they recover it. And Aminu kicks to McCollum. And it's off from 3-point range.
A a slight rebound advantage for them. One more column in their favor, and it's all adding up.
Well, you take a look at all of the stats, the team stats, that is, and that's one of the many areas that they've had the advantage. And as a result, they've got a big lead.
And a closer look here at the scoring breakdown. Cleveland.
Guys, the passing we've seen from them has been tremendous. Very unselfish.
Yeah, but also, they haven't missed a beat in terms of their fast break game. That's been equally as effective all night long.
And Cleveland making a change here. Dellavedova's checked in. And a switch here also for Portland. Harkless has checked in. Back to Lillard. Jacks up a three. Thompson with the rebound. Thompson's got four rebounds in this game.
Well, he just hasn't looked right to me. A bit out of sorts, if you will. Something's off with his mechanics, at least as I look at him.
McCollum dishes to Lillard. He feeds it to Aminu. He kicks it to Plumlee. Thompson comes with the double team. Six to shoot. And it's out of bounds to Portland. They'll retain possession.
Well, close to picking that one off.
Still a nice play to make sure that pass didn't reach its target.
I think he just wants to tinker with the game plan a little bit. I think that's a wise timeout.
And part of it, too, Greg, was he saw some things going on out there that he didn't care for.
Now a timeout called by Portland. Doris Burke has some information for us. Doris?
Hey, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Terry Stotts as he addressed his team. He told them to stick with what's worked to this point, saying, listen, they're giving us all the space we need inside. Let's take advantage of it. Keep working the ball inside the paint.
Thanks again, Doris. And Tristan Thompson gets the whistle that time. That'll be his second foul of the game. The dish now to Aminu. Here's Lillard. And lots of contact here. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Yeah, I like that they haven't lost their aggressiveness here in the second, despite being down.
That's exactly when you need to be aggressive, Greg. You know that. I mean, another good job, though, of drawing contact and getting to the free throw line. Of course, he didn't have an attempt there in the first half. He's hoping to be a little bit more active and aggressive here and draw some fouls here in the second.
Back to Love. The feed to Dellavedova. There's the three. Kept alive. Thompson with the bucket.
It's a plus five advantage for them in the rebounding category after that board.
Very steady with their work on the interior. Really a well-rounded effort overall.
To the wing right side. It's deflected. And a little over 3.5 minutes in the books so far here in the fourth. Out to Smith. And now Portland on the break. Here's Lillard. The lead pass was put in just the right spot. Lillard's got 11 points here in just the second half. And the Cavaliers call time here. They're leading by 9. 1:16 left in the fourth. Here's the screen. LeBron kicks to Smith. Good, and the assist goes to James. LeBron's got six assists now in the game. The pass to McCollum. From deep. Hooked down low that time, and he got the 3 second call.
Clearly a mental lapse and at an inopportune time.
Yeah, that's a terrible mistake, Greg, to make it any time, but it's really exacerbated when you make it at this time.
And it looks like just playing the last bit of this one out in what should be a nice win here for Cleveland.
Good point, Steve. And Clark, they had to battle for this win. There were times when it looked like it was maybe slipping away a bit, but they never let that happen, which I thought was a real credit to them.
I like their fortitude, their toughness, particularly in terms of dealing with adversity. Anytime things didn't go their way, they just put their nose down and stayed with it. And because of that, they were able to pull away.
And when you look at the season for these guys, they have amassed a lot of wins, 57, and adding in tonight, it'll make it 58.
And bragging rights between these teams were on the line today, and they put in some very good work to earn.
Sure did. I mean, this means they'll come out on top in the season series, 2-1 now. Got to be happy about that.
And you have to look back at this and see the huge game it was for James. He was doing everything right, and the points came in bunches. He definitely had the hot hand. And you can sense the fact that they didn't want to let the fans down here. It's been a fun night to be in the building.
Greg, it really has been. I mean, such a lively, vibrant atmosphere, and no doubt that played a part in the big win.
From 15 feet away, can't get it to fall. So we see the Cavaliers taking the win here. A confident win, and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
They certainly put on a good show here at home, and I think they felt they had the edge and that extra little bit of confidence.
And that about does it for the final game of the NBA regular season. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching, and we'll see you next time. But first, the post-game show with Ernie Johnson just a few aisles above us.
Until the end of time 지금 난 간절히 원해 한 조각의 peace of mind
Giants are looking to defeat their Eastern Conference rival going into this game. Great to have you with us, everybody, live on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. The last time these two teams met, it was the Cleveland Cavaliers who came away with the W against the Hornets.
And the way they attacked the basket in that game was unreal. I mean, after a while, the defenders seemed to just wave the white flag.
Yeah, like you said, I mean, that's what will happen when a team continues to attack the basket and come away with layups. The defense tends to get demoralized and deflated.
LeBron James.
Here's the starting group for the Charlotte Hornets. Kidd Gilchrist and Williams are at the forward spots. Kemba Walker is out there with Lee. And it's Zeller in the five. Lee kicks to Kidd Gilchrist. They double him with Irving. Back to Williams. That falls. Nice feed that time from Walker.
Well, Merry Christmas. I mean, that was a freebie.
Irving with it. He's picked up by Walker. And here's Love for three. Rebound by Williams. Here in the first, a little over a minute played so far. Out to the right wing. That's a two-pointer from Walker to the right side. Lee outside. Zeller against Love. A nice shot by Zeller. Zeller's got his first 2 points. Hornets on defense now. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of Miami.
Yeah, but when you shoot a percentage in the low 30s as a team, and they did that in that game, it is just not going to be your night.
No, it certainly is not going to be your night shooting that poorly. And so often when that happens to a team, it's hard to get out of that funk once you get into it.
Out of bounds.
Out of bounds. Cleveland takes possession.
And Steve Clifford might not be the most famous coach in the NBA, but he has plenty of experience, and everyone in the league knows exactly how well-versed he is as a coach.
Here's James, and that'll be Cleveland as it goes out of bounds. Cavaliers retain possession. We're just about 2 minutes into the first quarter. Irving for three. Once again off the mark by Cleveland.
And they're 1 of 5 to start this game. Just really haven't gotten into a flow offensively.
Back to Walker. Lee passes to Williams. Again, Williams missing.
When he's wide open like that, he'll rarely miss those.
Smith dishes to Irving. Some nice passing by Cleveland here.
The one-hand slam is so sweet when it's his hand doing the slam.
Oh, yeah, he is so smooth, even on a power finish like that.
And really, that's what makes him unique, that combination of power and polish.
Zeller, and the shot is good.
They are really doing a nice job establishing a presence inside early.
And watch, Clark, how the game plays out, because this is going to open things up on the perimeter.
Catching up on the changes for Cleveland. Mozgov, he's checked in for Thompson. Fry comes in for Kevin Love. Mon Shumpert's checked in for Smith. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Kyrie Irving. Out of bounds, Cleveland takes possession.
Let's see where Charlotte sits right now in the league rankings. First in fewest turnovers a game. Fifth in free throw percentage. And they're a top 10 team in three-point shooting.
And, you know, going back to their turnovers, fewest in our league, that shows you the intelligence they play with. You have to beat them. They are not going to do it for you.
On the wing, Shumpert. Good, and the assist goes to James.
You can't give him that shot. A few open looks are all it takes to get him in the zone.
Lynn kicks to Jefferson. Second chance shot. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
And you don't ever want to get into the habit of letting the offense get to the rim.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. I mean, that's the message they were sending with that foul. Nothing easy inside.
Some changes for Charlotte. Kaminsky comes in for Cody Zeller. And Jeremy Lamb subbed in for Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. For three, Fry. It's rebounded by Jefferson. On up the court. A nice shot by Lynn.
And I like how he puts himself in position there to finish on the break.
Yeah, you know, that's what we call seeing and feeling the game. Excellent read of how that play was going to develop and where the ball was going. That's stuff that you oftentimes can't teach, Greg.
Timeout is called, first of the game for the Cavaliers. They're coming into this game off that recent loss to Atlanta. Cleveland's gone 0-3 from three-point land. Nothing yet going outside. There's the pass to Dellavedova. From outside the arc, shot is off. Some solid defense there from Lynn. Now in transition is Lynn. Here we go. Kaminsky misses.
That's the kind of D you need when he's got the ball near the hoop. They were all over.
Fry passes to Dellavedova. Shumpert dishes to LeBron. And he slams it right down on top of Frank Kaminsky. The rim rattler.
Just a remarkable jam. These fans' jaws are on the ground right now.
That's straight up Showtime stuff right there, baby. Major highlight reel material.
Lynn kicks to Daniels. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock.
Just trying to get a break in the action to clear some heads here. I mean, they've gone ice cold, and not a bad idea to give them a little quick breather.
Yeah, they needed the timeout here. Anything to try to get them to forget about the missed shots and get themselves back on track.
And now the first timeout called here for the Hornets.
You know, obviously, you know, there's some things out there he does not like and wants to talk it over.
Well, Greg, you play and you envision yourself as a coach as well. So, you know, sometimes you need to make some adjustments.
That's tipped. And now LeBron pushing it up. No one back to stop him.
That's how you make an impact with defense. Once the steal is made, you know they're going to be scattered. The floor is open. Take care of business.
Always an advantage when you can get out in the open floor. You get much better rhythm offensively. And this lead, I think.
And we've reached the end of the first quarter. Cleveland ahead, up by four. It's the NBA on 2K Sports from Quicken Loans Arena. And now the second quarter just getting set to start. All right, well, a look at how the points have been generated so far. Scoring breakdown for the Cavaliers.
A lot of success from mid-range so far for them, guys. If nothing else works, they can always fall back on the jump shot.
And also another aspect of their game that's been super so far tonight is how they've been sharing the basketball.
And Charlotte looking.